Disney's Lorcana Into the Inklands is here. In this video covering the release, we're going to jump right into the Ruby and Sapphire starter deck. Now, right off the bat, you can see our two foils that we're going to have in the deck. Got this Moana here and this Scrooge McDuck here. Just really love the coloring of this. You know, the gold and blues and the greens look great. And I noticed this when I picked up this deck, but the confusing thing. So we got this Moana here. However, on the back, the Moana they show is not the Moana card that's going to be foil. Now, as you might be able to tell from kind of the glow there, it does have it in foil, so I think this is just a mistake on the back of the box here. Just interesting to note. We're also going to see our two locations that we are going to get with this deck, which is great to see because these are, you know, kind of like the new mechanic for this set here, is locations and kind of what they add to it. So we're going to, of course, see, you know, everything that does come in it, but also see how the cards, you know, work around these locations that are with them. Now, right off the bat, I can see this deck box actually opens differently than the previous ones. Previous ones, you'd open from the top here, just kind of lift off, but you can see it's kind of bent here. It's folded. It's not something you can peel. You actually have to open it from the side. Finger in there and open it up. You know, it means it's a little bit more messy if you like to keep your boxes or put stuff in them and just, you know, fitting it into the top. We do have our items there. Those. Got our box. So here's our deck. But we're going to first jump into the other stuff that's in here. And first, we're going to open that up at the end, see if we get anything cool in it. But let's say, first off, we got our lore counter here and our damage tokens. That lore counter will work with the little playmat they give you here. That's paper, which you can use to keep track of your lore here. I do like how this one is so visually distinct and unique to this set. You know, the previous two are very similar looking with like the purples and blues that, you know, could be kind of hard to tell which one is which. This one's very clearly on its own. And the other thing you're going to get here is this little book that has, you know, kind of like how to play and, you know, learning. It teaches you about like the characters, items, songs, and of course the new thing locations here. You know, just kind of all the things you're going to need to know and all the terms you'll need to know when learning to play this game, which is great for, you know, a starter deck to have. You know, for a lot of people, this is the first thing they're going to buy. They're going to buy this. This is going to all they're going to buy that and have it be all that they have. So having something to teach them how to play is good. So I'm just going to stick that off to the side for now. We're just going to jump straight into the deck here. Uh-oh. That did not fully break. There we go. Very loud. All right, and I'm just going to kind of move everything off to the side to give me more room to display all the cards here. But first up is going to be our two holos. Now, the first one we have here, and verifying it, is the Moana that we did see on the front of the box. Is a Ruby Moana Born Leader. It's a Floodborn, 4/4, 5 cost inkable, shift 3. Her ability is Welcome to My Boat. Whenever this character quests while at a location, ready all characters here. They can't quest for the rest of their turn. So a pretty good card to have characters at locations and keep them safe. So, you know, right off the bat, character that works with a location. Second one we're going to have here, and I kind of noticed the foil on mine here. I don't know if you guys can really see it on the video there, but it has like foil dollar bill signs covering the entirety top part of the card here, which, you know, is very thematically works well with the Scrooge Duck here. It's a 5 cost uninkable Sapphire card. It's the richest duck in the world, Scrooge McDuck. It's a 3/5 Storyborn Hero, and his abilities are I'm Coming Home, which is during your turn, this character gains evasive, which means they can challenge evasive characters. And during your turn, whenever this character banishes another character in a challenge, you can play an item for free. So that second part of the ability is pretty great for item decks. Now let's get with our cards here. So we got our commons. We got some Della Ducks here. 3 of those common cards, 2 constant inkable. We got, let's see here, 3 of the Hey Hays. We got 3 Hakamaros, nothing special with those just yet. Now, something important that we do have here is three of these Mauis, which will combo quite well with the Heihei's there. Where if a look at the ability there, whenever a character of yours named Heihei quests, this character gains plus one lore and loses Reckless this turn. Which means he'll be able to, you know, quest instead of having to challenge, and if you have multiple Heihei's out there that quest, that effect stacks. So we got some cards from the first set there. Minnie Mouse is just very good in general. One, I love the 1 and 3 cost cards there. Also good if you have the Floodborne Mini from the first set. And we got the Moana cards here. We got three of them that our main one there can shift onto, which is pretty good. And she's evasive, which keeps her safe until you can shift on. We've got this rare card here, which is basically a Ruby version of that Pinocchio card we got in set two, where, you know, it's 2 uninkable, 1 and 1, but gets you 3 lore. So, you know, works very well with those aggressive bounce decks. We got our Webby Quander or Vanderquack. So the letters there for a minute. Got three of those. We got some old cards again, 2 Dragon's Fires, which I mean are just pretty great cards in general, just to choose and banish something for 5 cost. We got Voyage, so got a couple more cards here that are going to work well with locations. We got Maui's Fishhook. So if you have a character Maui in play, which there's 3 of in this deck, you can use this item's shapeshift ability for free, and that ability is you exert it, and if you don't have Maui in play, you use 2 ink, and your chosen character will gain evasive until the start of your next turn, and or the chosen character can gain +3 strength during this turn. So pretty good either or card there. And then we're going to have 2 of these Sumerian Talismans, which is during your turn, whenever one of your characters is banished in a challenge, you can draw a card. So just a good item there for passive draw effect. Now for our location cards here, we got how many? 3 Agrabahs. So Agrabah looks pretty decent. You know, it's 3 cost, inkable, but it's only 1 to move a character there. It has 5 willpower, and it passively gives you 2 lore. So a pretty good location card here to kind of work with the 3 cards we have so far. Now, another kind of duplicate here, we got some Togsworth, where your characters with Reckless, you know, you can exert to gain 1 lore, which, you know, does work with the Maui that we had that is Reckless. We got Dewey here. Whenever this character quests, you can add their strength. Yeah, so support. Don't know why I was saying that out loud. But we'll see if we get the other nephews in this deck as well. Some more duplicates, just some simple Duke of Weaselton here, or just Duke Weaselton. We got Flintheart Glomgold. So it looks like this, the first part was the Ruby cards were centered around Moana, obviously, and the Sapphire cards, probably from what we see already, is probably going to center around Scrooge McDuck and DuckTales. So we got some more duplicates here with Flounder. Actually, you know, some Sapphire cards are going to do with Moana here as well. With the Grammatolas. Got our rare card here of Gyro Gearloose. So you can put an item card from your discard on the top of your deck. So I believe right now we only have 2 item cards. We'll see if we get any more in the Sapphire cards. Kind of keep him off to the side there. Oh, another one. So we got the Huey now to fit with Dewey. Which he also has support, and he's actually unique, and I'm guessing you're going to have all 3 of the nephews in here, because his second ability doesn't really work without it. But if you have characters named Dewey and Louie in play, you can draw 3 cards when he quests. Pretty good ability. Oh, and there he is. Speak of him. And he appears. We have Louie here. We got 3 of him, which looks like all the nephews just have support in general. We got Maid Marian here. Which is just, you know, a basic common card there. Interesting 5 cost. We got some Scrooge McDuck here. And you can kind of see from the... Actually, now I see the Moana has it as well, where... I thought it was just legendaries at first when I was looking at some of the legendaries, but you can kind of see through the text box to see more of the image. I wonder what kind of gets a card to have that ability. I notice almost all the Scrooge McDuck ones have coins for them at the bottom of theirs. But once again, 2 of those to fit in. Some more item cards here with the Vault Door. Your location and characters at locations gain resist +1. Just a great item to have if you're going to have a lot of locations out there. And speaking of locations, we got Motunui here, which is 2 cost inkable. You know, 1 to move a character there, 5 willpower. Only one lore, but its ability is pretty good, where whenever a character is banished while here, you may put that card into your inkwell face down and exert it. So I'd say overall, looking at the cards, we've got four item cards, which work well with the Gyro Gyarados here, with his specificity of items. We've got the three nephews, 3, 2, and 1 to work with that card. And when it comes to locations, I believe the only location cards that we have in this deck are... Oh, it looks like the Scrooge McDuck does work with items as well, which is decent. Yeah, it looks like it's Voyage and that Moana is kind of it when it has to do with locations. However, I think what makes up for it, especially compared to the first starter deck, when looking at that one, is that these locations do provide a little bit more. For instance, the Agrabah location provides you with 2 lore that you gain. And the Matsunui one gives you an ability where, if you have a character there and they're banished, they go into your inkwell. So overall, I'd say actually some kind of good synergy between the locations, either just being good locations or working well with the other cards that we have out here. Trying to see if there's anything else really. I like how there's small little combos throughout the deck, something that really builds up. When I look at like the duplicates of previous sets, nothing. I say the only cards that are really like stand out is Dragonfire, just because it's a really good card. And then Cogsworth, because he does something for that Maui. So you actually kind of, if you don't get any Heiheis, but you get some Cogsworth out, you can still have a way for him to gain lore for you, which is pretty decent. All right, cleaned up my mat here a little bit so I can get into the deck for the cards here. See what we get. We got Olympus would be that way. We got Della Duck. I will find my way. Magic Broom, King Louie, and Quick Patch. For uncommons, we got another Heihei, which would work well to throw into this deck here. And Matsunui, which would work well to throw in that deck there. Anala, Captain Hook. It's a decent card that you could throw in this deck, though it's, only really, like, the second abilities I'll get if other people are playing Peter Pans. Then we got a Helga Sinclair for our other rare here, and then we got a Milo Thatch as our holo. So not a bad deck there to pull, especially if I was just pulling this is all I had. It's really cool that I got some cards that I can mix into my starter deck there. So in terms of price point, this starter deck cost $20. Now I think from having a free pack in there, that's $6, so $14 for everything else, the amount of cards you get in the starter deck itself, it's way more than worth it. Get the little extras, the stuff in here for playing, especially if you're new to the game. I think $20 is great, especially I do think this is going to be the standout starter deck compared to, for the two that we get for Into the Inklands. I do think it synergizes with itself a little bit more, especially you get way more like showing off with the locations in this deck, with like how the unique abilities that you can get off the location, or with just kind of how decent it is and cards that can interact with a different location. That's everything you need to know about the Ruby and Sapphire starter deck for Into the Inklands. Now, if you're looking for more videos on Lorcana or, the new Into the Inklands release, you can check out the video or playlist here. Until next time, have fun and quest on.